Hi guys, welcome from Bulgaria and thank you for watching our series. In the course, I'm teaching you how to get started with xUnit writing Selenium tests. In the first module of the course, we talked about what is xUnit and why you should care. Now, in this module, I'm going to share with you how you can set up xUnit project in Visual Studio Code and how you can run your tests in command line. So, in this video, first, I'm going to show you what prerequisites you need, what you need to install, etc. So let's get started. As a prerequisite, you need to install the latest version of Visual Studio. Right now, the latest stable release is Visual Studio 2019, so I suggest you to use the community edition. Right now, I have opened the Visual Studio. I open the installer. You need to make sure to select this .NET desktop development that it's pre-selected. You need to make sure that it's installed. And also, by default, the Visual Studio installer will install the latest version of .NET Core, which right now is .NET 5. And we're going to use this cross-platform version of the framework. Basically, you can run and develop the tests on any operating system such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. And then how to create a new xUnit project. First, you need to click on File, then New Project. And in the search for template, you need to search for xUnit tests. Then you need to make sure that you select the C# template for xUnit. Then I'm going to click next and I'm going to give a proper name, sample xUnit test project. I'll use the default location and default solution name. I'm going to click next. Here you can choose a proper version of the .NET Core. Here again, I'm going to use the latest .NET 5 and I'm going to click next. To click create, and then Visual Studio will create a project for me with sample files, and all of the dependencies will be pre-installed for me. As probably know, the dependencies in the .NET are managed through NuGet packages, and I'm going to again how we open this. Right click. Manage NuGet packages, here a new window will pop up. And on the install tab, you can see that we already have everything that we need. First, for all unit testing frameworks in .NET, no matter whether it's xUnit, MS Test, or AnyUnit, we need this Microsoft .NET Test SDK, which again is pre-installed for us. And in order the test project to use xUnit, we need this xUnit and xUnit Runner Visual Studio, which are again installed for us. As a part of this empty template, there is one sample test. Again, if you recall the first video, I showed you that in order to mark a method as a test in xUnit, we only need to mark it with this fact attribute. And let's create two tests. First test, I will just make it pass, assert true. And I will create one more, right? I will name it second test. And I will name this file first test suite. I will rename the file manually and I will create a second test suite file. In total, we'll have four tests. If I rebuild the project, right click, build. How you can run the test in Visual Studio? Well, you need to go to test menu and open the test explorer from here. I already have it here. And here you will see all of your tests that we created. When you select the whole project, you can click run and all of them will be run. And you can see the results here. If there are failures, you will be able to see them here. Now, if we don't want to use Visual Studio, you can use the other popular tool that I mentioned called Visual Studio Code. It's open source, it's completely free. In order to use it, first you need to install the latest .NET. Again, the recommended version is .NET 5. You can check this site regularly. There are new versions each month. And when you install the Visual Studio Code, I already have it. Again, you don't have this visual editor for creating projects. This is why we are going to use the .NET CLI tooling for creating the projects and solution from command line. Here, I created an empty demos folder and I'm going to open the command prompt. And I'm going to change to D drive to my demos folder. And the first thing that I need to do is to create a new solution folder. So I will type .NET new SLN / O and the name of the folder of the solution and the name of the solution itself. I will name it unit testing using xUnit. Now I can change to the new directory of the solution. As you can see, if I open it, you will see the solution, right? And again, this .NET command comes when you install the .NET core. And now I can type and create the empty project. There is a special command, .NET new. And here we mention the name of the template. In our case, this is xUnit. And I can name it again, all, and xUnit simple test project. This is the name of my project, right? And as you can see, it was created successfully. Here is the new folder. If I open it, you will see that we have the same thing that I showed you in Visual Studio. The last thing that we need to do is to add this new project to the solution. Again, I can do it from the command line. .NET SLN add .slash name of the project folder / name of the project itself and the extension of the file, which is C# proj. And this will connect the solution to the project. And again, if we want, I already have installed the Visual Studio Code. Let me open it. Again, we need to open the folder itself. Here from open folder, I can select the folder of my solution. In this case, I don't want to do any updates right now. And here from the left, you can see the project, everything that I showed you before. Again, there isn't this visual representation of it, but here, this is the MS Build representation of the project. All of the dependencies are already pre-installed for you. Also, we have this, again, empty xUnit test file. We can create a second test. And their first tests. And I will again make it pass. Insert true. And now we are almost ready. Also, as you can see here, we have highlighting and also autocomplete in C#. In order to have all of that, when you click here at the bottom left, you can see and click on the extensions. I already, you need two important extensions. The first one is the C#, and the second one, in order to run the tests, you need .NET Core Test Explorer if you want to be able to run the test directly from Visual Studio Code. When you install this plugin here, .NET Core Test Explorer, you have this icon here, which is called testing. And when I refresh, click the refresh button, basically Visual Studio Code will recognize my new two tests, and I can click the play button and they will be executed. The same way you can debug the test and everything. As you can see, they already passed. This is the easiest way to basically develop your tests in a really lightweight code editor. And now, if we want to run, our last point was to run the test through command line. In order to do that, we can use again the .NET CLI here. I will open it again. And if we open the sample project that we already created, we can try to run the tests from here. I will navigate to this folder. It's on my C drive, which is the default one. I will change to this particular folder. And in order to run all the tests directly, as you know, first you need to build a project, restore the NuGet packages, but actually all of this can happen with a single command, .NET test. This basically will execute all of the tests that are part of your project, right? And there are many other options part of this command. As you can see, if you open MSDN, this is the Microsoft documentation, and search for .NET test, you will be able to see all of the different options. Maybe my favorite one is if you search for filter. There are different filtering options depending on the unit testing framework. But as you can see here in xUnit, we can search by, we can filter by fully qualified name. And this will allow us to execute the test only in one of my test classes. And if I type .NET test filter fully qualified name, first test suite, first sample test, this will basically should execute only one of my tests. I can even, here maybe I misspelled something. Yeah, basically this option here, we mentioned the name of the class. And this is why we executed only two of the tests. And this is how easy it is to run your tests in the CLI. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to write to the support of Lambda Test. Also, you can check their awesome blog. There is a special article about how you can get started with xUnit, writing Selenium tests, maybe all of the stuff that we're going to talk about in the video series. And also, don't miss the opportunity to get certified using their awesome program here. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.